Clang, clang, rattle, bing, bang, gonna make noise all day. Clang, clang, rattle, bing, bang, gonna make noise all day. Or you know you're on TV.
The sun is setting, sleepyhead. Pick up your toys, it's time for bed. I know. Oh, don't close it, don't close it. A bubbly bath to wash your toes, your belly, your arms, your back, your nose.
Clang, clang, rattle, bing, bang, gonna make noise all day. Yeah. Clang, clang, rattle, bing, bang, gonna make noise all day. That's me, the dad, when you're making noise.
So this is a little Harry. He's 8 months old now. A little tired, even though he slept hard. Yeah, you're not tired then.
This is Palmer Hutton. How old are you, big guy? He's 1 year old. Show your pointer finger. You show your pointer finger? No? Not right now. You show that you're one? He said, I'm one.
Oh, my word! What a save by Carter Hutton! Oh, is this a time to call a cop? You better believe it! Call a cop! Oh, my! He just scored! He robbed the blind!
I wouldn't stop him from being a goalie, but I would rather him not being a goalie because I know how hard it is, how stressful it is, how much pressure you have on you.
If he wants to be a goalie, then obviously he'll be a goalie, but I just see how much it affects everybody around me, so I'd rather have him play something where we can hide a little bit more.
And over the Buffalo line, long shot, the rebound! They score!
Carter Hutton right there, he makes the save and he leaves the big rebound sitting in front.
Panthers looking for Barkov, open net scores! Linus Ullmark could not get there, and the Panthers with an overtime win.
With goalies, it's so different, right? We bear, a lot of the load, right? If the goalies aren't playing well, it's hard to win hockey games. And I've played with so many different people, so, you just learn how to gel together, you have to. It's a support, but it's a competition as well. You need to push each other.
Hey, look who showed up.
He's gonna join the circus when he's done.
What's that?
You're gonna join the circus when you're done.
Actually, I might join the circus next year.
Yeah?
I just stop playing hockey.
Yeah.
Find my calling. Juggle tennis balls.
Well, Carter and Linus have definitely different styles. Carter is a goalie that works on reads and a little bit more movement in his game. I call it a flow goalie. He's flowing, he's moving a little bit more. Whereas Linus is more of an edge control, patient goaltender, uses his size to his advantage and reads and reacts off the release.
He's trying to hit me now.
One more.
He's trying to catch it and throw it at me, I think.
Carter's a lot of fun to be around and talk to, and he's a player's goalie. And what I mean by that is he kind of wins the room over, and people really respect that and really want to play hard for him.
Is this power play serious? We're that good? This penalty kill is sick. Teamwork, baby.
On the ice in practice, Carter will go back and forth with guys and challenge them. And so you hear a lot of chatting going on the ice and just gets more energy and more chemistry amongst guys on the ice. And that's how he kind of does it.
Hit the net, eh? Shut the power play down, eh, boys? Shocker.
He does everything right for me in my mind. He goes out there, he works hard, puts the team in front of himself, and he gets very excited and very happy whenever I get the chance that we win.
Again, 2-0 with a rebound, and then a D-side with...
He's a great student in the fact that Linus likes to bounce things off me, and I like to bounce things off him, and you really get to know a person by going back and forth.
Like, this is what we need.
It's the one shot, right?
Yeah.
I got it on autopilot some days, but I think he just cares so much that he's always trying to learn, and where for me some days you're just like, let's just get to work and get out of here kind of thing, so.
Okay! What's up with those floaters? Yeah, buddy! Under the pad. No goal. No goal.
Not that I don't have that excitement to be there, but at some days you're like, you just played the night before, you went to bed at 2 a.m. and you're back on the rink the next day and you're tired, and he comes up like, he's so chipper, and I'm like, holy cow, I need another cup of coffee.
Just gonna do a little bit of Henrik Lundqvist.
One of the reasons I love playing goalies is all the gears.
Could you beat this stick up for me, please? Right here on this. No, the white one. White one.
I didn't know you were, you know, had a preference.
At the start, you know, he'd come over and ask me about my gear, why I wore this, why I wore that. And I'm just like, I honestly don't know. I've had the same gear for, I kind of know what I like. I don't know why I like it. It works for me. And
we've got our cousin to this new sticks now, but
these ones are way better than the first ones I had. One thing, I think he could be a little bit more interested in gear, but that's my job right now. So I have to pull the weight of two guys on that area.
I think some of the younger generation of goalies now like really love gear and the design and, but it's good to have guys that are on the cutting edge too, so when new stuff comes out, they're always challenging it and you're kind of figuring out what works.
You know, pads, blocker, mask, definitely love the masks.
I asked him that the one time about his helmet, why he does the minions, and he just said he got a lot of like press on it and everybody loved it, so he just kept going with it, and he loves it too. Like, his gear is great. He's got the new gear with the Sabres logo in it, and it's cool. And or maybe I'll let him design my next set of pads. Hey?
The puck is dropped. Game three is underway from Rochester.
Well, with Linus, there's always been a plan in place to let him develop. And I think we didn't want to rush him coming in as he came over to North America. And Linus had the ability to go to Rochester and play a lot of minutes and really, really learn the grind of the North American game.
2 seconds and one. The Crunch has swept the Amherst.
Yeah, we had a great run. Then playoffs come and everybody's like, after we got crushed in three games, everybody's asking me, what happened? Why were you so bad?
Simple enough, I didn't make any saves. You know, I've tried to do my best out there. You know, I tried to put up numbers as help the guys out so they can do it.
I know why I'm bad, but I never really talked about it.
Next, please.
So the day before our first game in Syracuse, my grandmother passed away. I had the opportunity to go back. I could even go back to Sweden at the time. But I felt such a responsibility to watch the teams. Played it for 3 years, been through the hard times, and I wanted to reap the fruits. So I go out there and I just feel, you know, sad. Loss of thoughts. I tried to get it all out of my head. I play okay game, but okay doesn't cut it in the playoffs. You have to be great, you have to be good. Looking back at it, I should probably have gone home. For me, it's been super hard, but I'm also very grateful towards what happened. I'm still pissed off that we lost those three games, that we didn't go to the second round.
I think his path has been very good. He was a two-time American League All-Star. He got some NHL experience in his first few years here, so he got a taste of it, saw what it was like, saw what he needed to improve to be able to stay here. And now has come to the point where Linus is ready for the NHL and to challenge Carter Hutton night in and night out.
Beyond Blue and Gold is presented by New Era, the official cap of the Buffalo Sabres.